Once again, passenger truck, no Chicago flight 4418. We'll be start boarding just a couple minutes to get it.
As you can tell and see, me and my sister Kim, we are in the airport and we're heading to a very special location. We're going to the Netherlands and this is gonna be a trip, maybe of a lifetime, who knows? Neither myself or Kim, we've ever been to Europe. And then this is gonna be like our first official sister trip.
Yeah.
We'll be staying in Harlem, which is a city that's maybe 20-30 minutes outside of Amsterdam. And we chose that location because the hotels were a little cheaper there, and then the quality of hotels for me, I feel like were better compared to Amsterdam. But yeah, so far,
we're here just chilling. We got here super early.
We got here super early, so we just waiting and talking about what we're gonna do when we land and things like that. So we're gonna practice our Dutch. Okay, Kim, can you say one of these?
Well, we already know good morning.
How you say it? Guten Morgen.
You see how it's phonetically?
Guten Morgen. You try that one.
What?
Good day.
I would say goedemiddag.
Oh, it's goede.
Yeah, it's like the G's are like that. Goedenavond. Goedenacht. Hallo. Auschwitz.
Ooh, look, it's sorry.
Sorry.
Yeah, so we need to brush up on our Dutch. Just in case, you know, you never know.
Okay.
What's your name?
Ik heb honger, ik heb dorst. K2. What's your name?
Who hates you?
Who hates?
Who hates you? All right, I'm dead. One day you girls are gonna get first class, okay?
Yeah.
Cause he only had two times to do it on the third strike. You know what happened on the third strike? A turkey. We are officially in Amsterdam. We're about to catch our train to Harlem, which is where we're staying. This is about a bus. This is about a 40-minute bus ride to be smooth. And yeah, we kind of just ready to relax. But yeah, y'all, we made it. Kim is an international traveler.
I am. My legs have the marks to show it.
It just feels good to be here on solid ground and not in the earth. Yeah. And there's a lot of people watching that we're finna do. So I'll check in with y'all once we get to the hotel, once we get to Harlem, and you guys get to see what we're seeing. Bye. Stayed at the Hotel Lion Door.
Sit.
I'm so happy our room is ready. Thank you, Jesus.
So y'all, three must be around the corner.
Hey, you want to do the honors?
Oh. Yeah, guys.
Okay, this is cute. Put the AC on.
Yeah, it's hot in here.
Oh, I got a full-length mirror. Y'all know I love full-length mirrors. Okay, hold on. Let's get the AC cracking because it's a little toasty. Heating up, cool down. We're going to bring that all the way down.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. It's to the station. Okay, cool. We can do a lot of people watching from here. Mm-hmm. This is a really cute boutique hotel. I think it's a decent amount of space for a European hotel.
Our bathroom's lush.
Check it out. The bathroom lush? Okay, it's bigger than I expected.
Yeah.
Based on how that door was looking. Turn this on. How do you turn the light on? Oh, that's a plug. Oh, thanks. So this is the bathroom, shower, toilet. Down there. Okay. Not bad at all. We in the same bed but different mattresses. So, okay. Come in. Here's the room. I think it's nice.
We made it. Ooh, yeah.
Okay. So this is our neighborhood. They got like a barbershop right there. Some sushi. We're going to this place called Jetty's. And so that's where we're heading. It's literally like a block away from our hotel. I hope you can hear that. That bus just drove by. But yeah, Jetty's is a block away from our hotel. And we are hungry. This is a little shop. There's Jetty's. Yeah, like window view, and then you just see a whole bunch of people like riding their bikes or walking by. So this is a very active city.
Beginning.
I got a turkey sandwich because I just, you know, want to play it safe. And Kim has a pumpkin curry, and she says it's really good.
And so while we were sitting here, me and Kim was just talking about like, wow, we're really in Amsterdam right now, and we kind of planned on this trip being really low-key, just a vibe, not really too explosive, but just activities. So today, after we leave for lunch, hold on, y'all, my mouth watering. After we leave for lunch, we're gonna go get set up to get a local number so we can start being able to use our GPS around here, and then we're gonna walk around some parks.
I never ate a sandwich with a fork and knife like this. So right now we're about to walk to the park in the Netherlands. The homes, the buildings, the people on the bikes. So we're gonna go to this park. Let's read this theme. Welcome in Hakunu Park.
What?
They have owls and birds and things. And a flower. So we're gonna walk. Like when you feel the energy and it's like very calming and very tranquil, that's what this neighborhood feels for me. It feels super relaxed. It doesn't feel high stress, too energy. Because you know, it's crazy though that energy is transferable. So all people, you got all these people in the world and they anxious, they stressed out, that becomes like a big ball of stress in the city. But here, it just ain't real chill. And as you can tell, back in the room, it's currently 8:49 p.m. here, and it's like 1:49 back at home. Right now, we're gonna just rest. Dinner was good. We stopped by a supermarket to get snacks for the room. Probably watch a movie, and after that,
getting some things squared away, going to the canal tour tomorrow, and then visiting some museums as well. But right now, we're going to bed. Good night. Farewell to you, my friend. I will see you tomorrow. Peace out.
Day two. Marker.
Day two, like Kim just said, we are about to head to the phone store again because there's still mishaps with the phones. But anyway, after that, we're going to do a canal tour and then go get lunch.
So now we're going to head out. We're excited. You know, day two and how? What are you going to do about it?
Yeah, probably go to a museum.
And then we need to figure out our situation for day three tomorrow, which is going to San Fort, which is a beach town. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to be by the ocean, you know, maybe dip our feet in some sand.
So, you feeling better? You feeling good?
Guys, can I be real with you?
No, you don't have to.
Or after finally getting a phone that is showing us where to go.
It's a little bit of a funny day because we have some sunshine and it is a little chilly. In case you get chilly, I have blankets as well. Seats are warm because they're black, yeah. And you have black, you're warm. Yeah, there you go. You're dressed to the occasion, man. And where are you from, ladies?
St. Louis, Missouri.
There you go.
Yeah, we've been to a few games and whatnot.
Yeah. Ready to rock and roll? Holland is actually just the western side of the Netherlands, but it's easier to root for a national soccer team, Holland, 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 than the Netherlands, the Netherlands, the Netherlands.
Oh, here it is, Kim.
We stopped by Frans Hals Museum, which was about a 15-minute walk from our hotel. There was a $16 ticket fee, but the person working the front desk hooked us up with a student discount.
It pays to look young, honey.
Here is some of the amazing art that we saw. The museum also has audio tours to get a personalized experience of the meaning and background of the artist.
So you can listen and learn about the pieces, and some of them had some crazy stories behind them. I was like, whoa.
Right now, we're currently in the Vons Frans Hall.
What?
We're in this museum. You see? And you can draw a portrait. There we go. Kind of three, we're gonna show you portraits.
There's a comment below which one is your favorite, which one do you think is a little worse?
Hey, chill out.
I still look like an old lady.
Let me see what it is. Oh, Kim's is really nice.
Are you... Are you going to keep going or are you going to put it on?
Okay, so now we're going to put ours on the wall with the other portraits.
It looks like I'm side-eyeing you. We have not eaten since we woke up this morning, and it is almost 5 o'clock, y'all. So, it's time. Yes,
we need to eat. I'm hungry.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how hungry would you say that you are?
Eight.
She's an 8, y'all.
Mm-hmm. Now, if I was a 10, I'd be on this floor on this cobblestone.
Okay.
This is nice, isn't it?
Yeah. And there it is, the place that we'll be eating.
Oh wow. These are fire. They taste like shrimp funyuns. I know that sounds crazy, but they taste fire. And we're at an Indonesian restaurant.
There might be traces of their.
And their menu has, like, I guess, the backstory of the history of the food. So it's really cool.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Okay, y'all. So. We're at dinner at this place called Thrill Grill, and they closed, but they're letting us do takeaway, so we'll try to find some place to sit and eat outside and not have to go back to the hotel. We got some food coming, and hopefully it's good, because if not, what was the reason?
This is our view from dinner. Gonna eat the burger. I got the Asian chicken.
I got a Tel Aviv, vegan Tel Aviv burger.
Oh, look at the moon, sis. Is that a planet?
Uh-huh.
I'm in the New York state of mind. Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm telling you. Walking the streets of Harlem at night, seeing what the nightlife is like. Yeah, it is. Let's see. Which way, sister? It's my phone telling me to get my butt to sleep. About to head to the hotel, relax, finish the movie we fell asleep on.
And then we can start getting ready for Sun Porch and you by the beach, so.
Yes.
It's gonna be really nice shots, guys. Really nice. Prepare yourself for cinematic views of the beach in Harlem.
Wait until you Harlem. See it. It's cute in Harlem, y'all. It is, it is.
The volgende station is Overveen. Station Overveen.
Whoa! I don't know if I can go further. I'm sinking. Where's she going, y'all? Jellyfish. Definitely jellyfish. I've never seen one before.
Okay.
I gotta learn how to do these dances.
No. Go tap. Get it. Woo! You doing like some type of sorority dance.
All I hear is heavy breathing.
Cut up. That's my favorite part. They cut up.
It's time to go to bed. It's midnight, ain't it? Girl, yeah, it is.
Morning, day four. Just finished breakfast, and now we're on our way to Zan's Zar.
What?
It's actually Zan's Zashan's.
And we're going to visit the windmills.
So far, so good. Today's been, you know, cool. We woke up earlier than we usually have.
Okay,
bye. He said something about overbeing, too.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, Kim, how was the train ride?
I got almost squished by a door, guys. So we would say, come on, girl. Are you okay?
No, when I turned around, all I heard, ooh, all I see is hat, her vest in the tote bag that she got in her hand. I'm like, what is going on? Come on, fight for your life. Get through the door. But we got to. And now we're headed to the window.
I got to by myself.
Hey, sometimes that's the best way to do it. So we're going to go to the windmills.
Look at all those windmills.
Yes, yes, Creed. Yes, get your mom and get your life.
So Zans of Friends,
Zans of Shans,
offers $29 passes to different museums or attractions. Here's the guy slowing down and stopping the blades with a rope. That's all it takes.
Windmills, we stopped by the vegan bakery and I was amazed at how many options there were for me, I mean for us, to try out. We ended up getting cinnamon rolls, cupcakes, scones, and the garlic pesto rolls. They were amazing.
We stopped by a nice Indian spot after our excursion from Zan's Zashan's windmills, and the food looks really good. It's a really cute little area. Everything's just so pretty out here. It's quite a shame we don't have this in the States, I've got to admit. But yeah, we're gonna order some food and y'all will see it when it comes out.
So spoiler alert, didn't actually
actually record, but Tepper got the butter chicken and I got the veggie vindaloo. It was amazing. The owner was so sweet and we had the whole outside to ourselves. It was perfect.
Yeah, it was pretty. We were just sitting up in the window. Pretty.
All right, final day vibes. Okay, today is the full day of being here in the Netherlands, and we're going to be going to Amsterdam for the whole entire day. We're going to be going to some museums, going to be going to some vegan eateries as well as some parks possibly, and see you once we get to Amsterdam.
We are in Amsterdam, finally, finally.
Crossing the street in the Netherlands is very, very, you have to look both triple ways. Like, you gotta look out for buses, you gotta look out for trams, you gotta look out for bikes, cars, motorcycles, all the things. They're all sharing the road, which is pretty cool though. Here it is.
So this is a very important building and what we would consider black owned. You have to understand how rare it is to have a black owned building, especially in an old part of a city like this. The person that made it possible for the Black Archives to come here, he unfortunately passed away last year or 2 years ago. He basically said to Mitch, and Mitch was gaining a lot of traction, to say, hey, if you need a space, you can have this attic if you clean it up.
It's yours.
It's yours. You can use it. Okay. Or they made a deal.
So that's where it started.
Now it's all about, okay, we have this archive. Not a lot of people are actually really reading, right? So how do we bring it to people? Like exhibitions, talks, like programming. Mm-hmm. And my way would be try to do something very boring like a book club, but make it, give it sauce. And we have freestyles, we have poetry connected to the book. So that's what we're trying to do.
Out at the park of a museum park with Tepra beside me. Hello to the camera.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm being nosy.
Tepra's
being nosy.
We're waiting before we get inside the Moco Museum.
We just finished the Black Archives.
How was that experience?
It was really nice. We enjoyed it. We learned a lot about like black experience in the Netherlands, you know. Interesting stuff.
We were able to get like a little private history lesson, something unscheduled, something that was very appreciated that they took the time to actually walk us through. So if you're ever in Amsterdam and you want to learn a little bit more about the history of black people in Amsterdam and their experiences in Amsterdam and some of the grassroots organizations and movements that they're trying to start, definitely recommend going to them and kind of getting that information and seeking that knowledge for sure. We're gonna stop by another museum, and then after that we are going to go to the park maybe or get something to eat, and then we have the Zoku House Amsterdam where they have the live jazz music playing tonight. Tepper, any words?
I feel very peaceful right now in this park. It's nice.
And that's all she wrote.
Thank you.
Here are the views from the rooftop. They were absolutely gorgeous. We enjoyed listening to the live music here. Afterwards, we went to our hotel, chilled for the rest of the night before we flew out the next morning.
Hey, last day. We are officially about to hop on our flight back home. And we are happy to be going home. And we're also happy that we made this trip. So thank y'all for watching. Appreciate you all stopping by and joining us on our trip to the Netherlands. And hope to see you on the next one. Bye-bye.